Will Smith was just relaxing at his house until he heard music coming from down the street. He went over to check it out. When he arrived, he saw a man standing behind a table DJing. This man was Jeff Townsend, later known as Jazzy Jeff. Jeff told him he was missing a rapper, so Will decided to fill in. Everyone loved it. Later on, Will and Jeff started a duo called DJ Jazzy Jeff and the Fresh Prince. A year later, Will and Jeff released their first album, Rock the House, with the most popular song, Girls Aren't Nothing But Trouble. Which was average, but the next album was a huge success. He's a DJ, I'm the Rapper was the name of the album. The reason the album was a success was because of the song Parents Just Don't Understand.
Parents are the same, no matter time, no place. They don't understand that us kids are going to make some mistakes. So to you other kids all across the land, there's no need to argue, parents just don't understand.
The duo won a Grammy for this song and made a large amount of money. He thought life was always going to be like this. When they released their next album, In This Corner, it flopped hard. They made no money off this, and Will had already spent all of his money. Soon, the IRS was taking all of Will's stuff. Will said that one of the worst things he experienced in his life was being famous but broke, because people would recognize you when you're sitting next to them on the bus. One time, he was sitting in his misery on the couch, and his girlfriend forced him to go out to a party he was invited to. When Will arrived, he bumped into a guy called Benny Medina. While he was talking to him, Benny pitched the idea of the show, but didn't know what to call it. While he was talking, Benny decided to introduce Will to the person that was helping him produce, Quincy Jones. Quincy asked Will what his rap name was. Will replied, The Fresh Prince. Cool, cool. That's what we will call the show. Seconds later, he handed Will a script and said, if I'm using your name, you should at least audition for the show. I'll give you 5 minutes to memorize the lines. Will politely declined, but Quincy wasn't giving up. Smith said, fine, give me a week. Quincy started being sarcastic, saying the head of NBC is here. I'll ask him to come around in a week. You know what happened? We won't be able to do that. So 3 weeks. And these words have stuck with Will his whole life.
Be good, or you could take 10 minutes right now, and you can change your life forever. And I was like...
So Will auditioned, and again, everyone loved it. He got the main character straight away. Other actors that were chosen for The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air didn't like the fact how the main character was a rapper, but they took a chance on him and it paid off. One of Will's most popular acting scenes was in The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. This scene was about Will's dad coming back after 14 years then leaving again. Will wasn't acting in this scene, he was only meant to say, I don't need him, and walks off. But he grew up without a dad, and he knew how it felt and released his feelings.
You ain't got to do nothing, Uncle Phil. You know, ain't like I'm still 5 years old, you know? Ain't like I'm going to be sitting up every night asking my mom, when's daddy coming home, you know? Who needs him? Hey, I learned how to drive. I learned how to shave. I learned how to fight without him. I had 14 great birthdays without him. He never even sent me a damn card. To hell with him! A whole bunch of kids, I'm gonna be a better father than he ever was. And I sure as hell don't need him for that, because ain't a damn thing he could ever teach me about how to love my kids. How come he don't want me, man?
Actor James Avery, which is Uncle Phil in this clip, says to him while they're hugging, now that's acting. This scene got him noticed by actors and acting agencies. And soon he was getting offers left, right, and centre. Martin Lawrence was asked who he wanted to act beside in his hit movie series, Bad Boys. He took a chance on Will, and it paid off. He was asked to be in Men in Black and declined. And again, his girlfriend persuaded him.
You know what the difference is between you and me? I make this look good.
He was offered to be the main character in The Matrix, but declined, because he was starring in his own movie called The Wild Wild West, which he regretted, but was also glad he didn't do it, because Keanu Reeves wouldn't be where he is today if he didn't do it. Independence Day was his first movie to hit the box office. When this happened, he wanted to become one of the biggest actors this planet has ever seen. It's safe to say he's done that.